Welcome to worship at Westminster Presbyterian Church and to our inclusive family of faith. We are glad you're joining us on YouTube. Be sure to click like and subscribe to our channel so you never miss a thing. This morning is Theological Education Sunday, a day where Presbyterians around the nation celebrate the gift of seminary training for pastors. Fulfilling the 3-year Master of Divinity degree is a requirement for all Presbyterian pastors and shows our commitment to studying the Word as well as the world of ministry. Usually on this Sunday, we have a student from Austin Presbyterian Theological Seminary join us in person to preach, but that's not possible this year. Yet we will still hear a word proclaimed from Austin Seminary senior Kailey Gray, whose home church is right here in DFW. We'll also take time to lift up in prayer the two in our congregation, Claire Kennedy and Laura Westerlidge, who are actively discerning their call to ministry. Our friends in Austin send their greetings. Greetings from Austin Seminary on behalf of President Ted Wardlaw. We are especially grateful this theological education for your role in preparing men and women for ministry of the Word and Sacrament. As you can imagine, this new academic year brings unprecedented challenges for the Austin Seminary learning community. It takes seminaries and churches together to prepare someone for the work of ministry. A congregation nurtures a person who identifies a call to ministry, and a seminary educates and equips that person to return to lead worship, preach, teach, and pray in a local church, a chaplaincy, or some other ministry setting. We look forward to an exciting, if challenging, year at Austin Seminary. For more information about the degree programs, as well as learning opportunities for even lay members like you, you can visit their website, austinseminary.edu. Thank you again for your partnership, your support, and your prayers for the Austin Seminary community and all our Presbyterian seminaries. Only working in partnership with individuals and congregations can we accomplish the goals set before us, to educate and equip those who will lead Christ Church into God's future.
Hey everybody, I'm David.
I'm Sloan.
I'm Brett.
And we're the Farrell family. We just wanted to say how much we've appreciated you all during the pandemic and how we miss seeing you so much in person like we used to. And with that in mind, how much we're really looking forward to seeing you in church sometime soon. So until then, take care of yourselves. And thank you all, and we'll talk to you very soon.
Bye.
Hi, y'all. Welcome to Westminster. We're sitting down on the job today, but next time you come, we'll be standing up, and you can meet you.
we're just so looking forward to the day when we can see you all in person and give you a hug. We miss you so much.
And now join us in our call to worship. The Lord is about to do a new thing. Speak, O God, for your servants are listening. There are varieties of gifts, services, and activities, but there is one Spirit, one Lord, and one God. The Spirit of God renews the earth. Bless the name of the Lord.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them, they turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard I will hold.
trusting in God's grace, let us confess our sin together, saying, Holy and merciful God, in your presence we confess our failure to be what you created us to be. You alone know how often we have sinned in wandering from your ways, in wasting your gifts, in forgetting your love. By your loving mercy, help us to live in your light and abide in your ways for the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Friends, we come to this font knowing that in God's waters we are named and claimed as beloved children, beloved family, belonging to Jesus Christ. Who has the right to judge us? Only Christ. And Christ lived for us. Christ died for us. Christ was raised for us. Christ reigns in power over us. Christ even prays for us. Thanks be to God, our sins are forgiven. Alleluia! Amen. And now let us share the peace of Christ. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Let us pray. Gracious God, as we turn to your word for us, may the Spirit of God rest upon us. Help us to be steadfast in our hearing, in our speaking, in our believing, and in our living. Amen.
Let us pray. Living God, help us this day to hear your holy word, that we may truly understand. That understanding we may believe, and believing we may follow in all faithfulness, seeking your honor and glory in all that we do. Through Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. Our scripture reading today comes from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verses 4 through 11. Listen for the word of the Lord. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom, and to another the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, the discernment of spirits. To another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All of these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. Holy wisdom, holy word, thanks be to God. I believe the word Spirit is perhaps one of my favorite biblical words and principles. The Greek word for spirit that is used in this passage from 1 Corinthians is the word pneuma. Pneuma, as well as the Hebrew word for spirit, ruach, means spirit as well as wind. There are so many exegetical and theological interpretations that have been done about the spirit being the wind or the breath of God. While I have done a lot of my own conceptual and theological ponderings on this concept, there is one distinct memory I have of when I felt the Holy Spirit of God at work in my entire body as a gusting wind. In January of 2020, I had the opportunity to go with my dean and a group of classmates to a seminarian interfaith weekend retreat up near Lake Texoma. One afternoon, a rabbi who was speaking at the retreat offered to lead a prayer walk for anyone who wanted to join. While this sounded like a potentially beautiful experience, I was quite hesitant to go due to the weather. It was cold and incredibly windy, but after some convincing by my friends and probably a bit of work by the Spirit, I chose to go. We walked through the trees, stopping to offer blessings of praise and thanks to the beautiful bits of creation we so often take for granted. And then we wove our way down to the beachfront of the lake. We were invited to spread out into our own spaces and spend some time with God in prayer. So I walked down the beach, found myself a rock that looked out at the water, and took a seat. As I sat on my rock, shivering in the cold wind, and looked out at this little sliver of creation, Numa came to mind. I could see and feel the Spirit of God present in the wind. And wind is an interesting experience when you start to think about it. It is always present and yet often goes unnoticed. It is easy to ignore the constant movement of the air around us on a typical day outside. It's generally not until the wind picks up and becomes incredibly strong that we are forced to acknowledge its presence. On this particular day, down on that beach, the wind had grown so strong that I was forced to acknowledge its presence. If you haven't noticed, I have a lot of hair. This can quickly become a struggle on a windy day. As the wind was blowing my hair in swirls around me, I was forced to turn and face directly into the wind. The strength of it on this day made me pay attention. I think there are a lot of parallels that can be explored here with the Spirit. It is always present, yet can often go unnoticed. Many of us have had those particular moments, however, when the Spirit has felt incredibly present and forced us to look at the presence of God in our world head on. It is in these times that we can begin to see something beautiful. When I looked into that wind, I was able to see the way the wind hitting the water was creating beautiful waves across the lake. While it is our choice how much we choose to surrender to it, the Spirit does and will always affect the ways we move in life. I also loved the way that the same wind was hitting all of the water atop the lake, and yet each wave took its own unique shape and force. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. In these times of crisis in which so much is being asked of us, I invite you to ask yourself where in your life you feel the Spirit moving. What direction is it pushing you? For some, it has been a call to make masks for their communities. Others have felt pushed towards continuing to feed their neighbors on the streets. Some are called to show up to their job every day in hospitals, grocery stores, shipping companies, and schools. There is an immense variety of activities that we are called to in these new and changing times. We must remember that the activating source of each of these callings is God and God's Spirit. As I continued sitting in the wind and talking to God on the beach that January day, I also noticed the way that the waves crashed into the rocky shore, splashing over boulders that stood in the way and reshaping the sand beneath it. I believe that in a similar way, our responses to the Spirit of God have the power to change the world. We may not be able to get rid of a virus overnight. We also can't control the acts of others, but we must recognize, own, and utilize the power that we do have. The response of individuals around the globe to social distance, stay at home, and work safely have had an incredibly clear impact on the flattening the curve of the current pandemic in their communities. Daily global CO2 emissions decreased by 11 to 25% during the shutdowns that this pandemic resulted in. I do not in any way want to glorify this pandemic we are facing or the terrible effects it has had on so many. What I do hope for us to see by sharing these facts is the power that we have as individuals to change the world in which we live. The claim that we cannot control the circumstances of climate change, world health, and the lives of our brothers and sisters in faith simply cannot stand. We have power. You have power. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. It is up to us to attend to the movement of the Spirit as we make decisions on how we are going to shape this world right now and in the future as we move through and past this most recent crisis. May you feel the Spirit of God in your life and follow where'er it may blow. Amen.
Oh.
Now we gather around our Lord's table to lift up the prayers of our community. Let us pray. Fresh as each morning, you come to us, crafter of manna. Your grace rests gently upon us, waiting to be gathered to become the bread of life we share throughout the day. Fresh as compassion's justice, you come to us, servant of the poor. Choosing to give as you desire, you show us the last so we can make them first in our hearts and hopes. Doing no wrong, you make us right with God for all time. We lift up those who need to be first in our hearts and hopes. For those who are hurting, for those who are grieving, for those who are waiting, for those who are sick, for those who feel alone, for those struggling to accept our new normal. Fresh as the water which turns a desert into a meadowland of flowers, Spirit of uninterrupted grace, you come to us. When we would grumble, you give us the gospel to live out. When we would protest, you teach us songs of praise. When we would utter laments, you fill us with God's laughter. We give you thanks for all the seminary students and those pursuing your call to ministry, God of good gifts. We particularly lift up Claire Kennedy and Laura Wisterlidge in our Westminster family, who are committed to following you and living out the gospel with strong leadership and lots of laughter. God and community, holy in one, refresh us with your presence as we pray as Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As the Spirit blows into our lives, we offer a part of all that we have received in gratitude for God's call. Pause worship now to offer your gifts online or in the mail. As you go out into the world, have courage, hold on to what is good, return no one evil for evil, but strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, and help the suffering. Honor all people. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.